This has been one of our weekly Library Explorer sessions. So it runs every week and we get mainly under fives, but occasionally in the school holidays we get older children coming along as well. And they come along and we do stories and we have rhymes and we have a craft activity, singing, and like today we had a visit from a special guest bear. The sessions tend to have quite a bit of routine to them because we like to build on the routine that the children recognise. So we start off with singing a hello song, getting all the children to wave their hands. And then we sing hello to the children individually because it's really good that they know that they're being welcomed individually by name. Then we have our library bag that we bring out every week, and there's always different props or activities in there that relate to the theme of the week. So today we have teddy bears in there because it was teddy bear themed stories. Then we have some stories, and then today we had making paper plate teddy bears, but it'll usually be some kind of simple craft activity.
Yeah, there's your glue there, look. Right, colour yours in, look, all of it like that, look. That's it.
I think it's always assumed that libraries will run story times, so we've always tried to do that, but I mean, especially at the minute, we want children to come in and we want children to see that libraries have changed, and parents to see that libraries have changed, and they're not stuffy, quiet places where you have to just come in and whisper and be afraid to touch the books and be told off for having dirty hands. We want them to see that libraries are kind of fun and exciting places, and you can come and sing and share stories together, because that's kind of what it's all about, really. It's not just necessarily us reading to the children, it's the whole thing of sharing the stories together and seeing that it's a lovely space that everybody can use together. And people who are coming in without children will quite often stop and look at what's going on. So that kind of word of mouth recommendation that they're seeing, it's a really fun place to be.
You do the booklet boogie and you turn around slowly.
There's lots of things they benefit from. The social skills, just the social interaction of being with other children that they gain from. The language, because obviously we're reading different stories to them, we're singing different rhymes to them. It helps develop their language and their vocabulary, which is obviously going to be beneficial when they go on, when they start school. And just seeing that it's a lovely, fun experience coming to the library. And we want to encourage lots of parents and carers to share nursery rhymes with their children, because obviously babies and children, if they hear the rhymes over and over again, they learn them themselves, and it's really good for developing language and literacy skills at an early age. So it's great that they can come along and kind of all share the rhymes together. We get lots of families that come back again and again, so some of the children that were at the session today have been coming to us since they were tiny babies, and it's been lovely to see how they've grown up, how they've developed relationships with the other children in the group, how they've developed relationships with us as well, and how they've kind of grown to love particular types of stories. So when they were tiny, some of them would obviously wander off partway through and wouldn't sit through a whole story. Now they're sitting, they're joining in with the story. You've got some of the children, there's one little boy who really likes his superhero stories, so he'll come in and we'll try and find him the kind of Spider-Man books and the Batman books that he really likes to look at. Or, you know, children will come in, they really like Thomas, and if we haven't got a Thomas book, we can find other things for them as well. So it broadens their range as well, that they're not just, my child will only read Thomas books. It's like, well, here's some other train books, take these away. And they'll read those as well. So it's really nice to kind of broaden the range of things that they're reading at home as well.
4 or 5.
Brilliant. Oh, that is superb, isn't it? I love that.
Several weeks training we had into the sort of things that would be going on, and that's when we realised that it wasn't actually reading stories to children. We were helping, I suppose, more in the way of taking names, giving labels when the children came in, because the people from the library who actually organise it, obviously they need to be with the children. They're reading the stories and doing the songs. We get them to sign in the names of the children, their name. We find out if they're a member of the library, if they're a member of the Imagination Library, and if they belong to the scheme that's going on here today. If they're not, we sign them up for the different things, give them a folder with all the details about these sessions, and they have a passport which gets stamped each time they come, and when the child's got 6 stamps in the passport they get a certificate, and this goes on, and each 6 stamps they get another certificate, and these can go up in the bedroom. So it encourages them to come, and hopefully coming here and seeing all the books and having stories read to them is going to encourage them to read and enjoy books.
We've got a pink one,
haven't
we?
That'll do, Chloe.
Are you ready? Steady. And go. You got it.
Good dad.
Yeah. Brilliant.
That's it, good girl.
Right, let's find your certificate.
I think it gives us more of an insight into what's going on in the community. And I think extra pairs of hands are needed, and obviously there isn't the money to be paying for the people that are needed. So those of us that have got some time, obviously, have volunteered to do this.
Anybody can come. We have no qualms whatsoever who comes in. We have mums and dads coming, we have grandparents coming, we have childminders coming. We sometimes have nurseries coming as well and bringing groups of children. So it really is open to anybody.
Oh. You've got a big scrunchy mouth.